back to my channel. So in this video I want to show you how I take my notes for language learning, and right now I'm learning Japanese and Korean. So in this video I want to show you how I take notes, and do I review these notes, how often do I study every week, and what things do I write down. And personally I always interested in how other people are taking their notes, and all of my notes I do write down in a notebook. I know some people do use their computer or their iPads, but I like to really write things out. So I only have notebooks and not Word documents or an iPad that I take my notes on, or programs that I use or apps to take notes on. So I will start out with my Japanese language learning. For Japanese, I use three different notebooks. And at first I had like one notebook, which was this one, I think, because most of the things that I learned in Japanese were things from the internet, so YouTube and websites. And this one is specifically for Japanese from YouTube. I wrote it down. So why do I separate my notes? Like things that I learn from textbooks, things that I learn from the internet, like YouTube. Because sometimes things that you learn from internet have some mistakes, and things that you learn in textbooks are not always the things that you like use in your daily life, in your daily speech. So most of the time I am learning from YouTube, but I like to keep those notes separately from the notes that I have like from textbooks. So my notebook for language learning for YouTube is very random. So I have all of these lessons that I did someday. So one of the things that I really learned from the internet is how to use katakana, and to learn the sounding of katakana, and how to write them, and how to really use katakana. So the whole katakana alphabet I learned through internet, and I just wrote it out many times, and reviewed it a couple of times, and then just started writing words. Then I started out with kanji, but kanji I learned in a lot of other ways, not only just writing things out, but I did wrote out most of the radicals. So this is all the lessons that I have like taken from YouTube, and yeah, I just write everything out, and sometimes I need to look up things in the dictionary, and then I write some extra stuff. There is not really a system for colors, so I use all kinds of different colors, but I like to use my main notes. I like to write my main notes or in like blue or in black, and then all of the furigana explanations I try to write down in a different color. And for example, when I learned katakana, a lot of the soundings, like all of the soundings, I would write down in romaji, but then as more I progressed in the learning, I stopped using romaji in my notes. So that's one of the things that you can see in my notebooks, is I stopped using romaji entirely in my note taking, because I think it's better to write it down or in katakana or in hiragana. So when I started out learning the radicals of kanjis, I wrote down the radical, then the different kanjis. They're not really pretty because this was my first time writing these kanjis. And then the soundings in hiragana and katakana, and the English translation. So I didn't use any romaji at all. A lot of the grammar notes, the kanji. Most of the time when I write in Japanese or in Korean, I use my black pens. So that's like one color system that I use. So I use my black pens, and then the explanations I wrote down in just normal blue pens, like the regular gel pens. And then the soundings I wrote down in different colors. So that's one system that I used. And when I start out learning grammar, also from YouTube videos, I try to write down every grammar point in pink. I don't know why pink, but it stood out. So then you have like this whole page in pink, because this is only grammar. Then for a while I started using the system that I would like give every word a color, because then I could see which word had which translations. I will show you to make it more understandable. So I have like this sentence, and then every word has some color in it, and then the English translation has also the same colors for the same words. So then every time I could look back and see like, oh, which is this word, and then I will go to the English translation and quickly spot the right word. But I stopped using this system because it just takes too much time, and then I would focus more of my note taking than on really learning things. And I think, well, most of the words I could remember, so it wasn't helping my studies. So I stopped doing that, and then I started just using two colors. So one color for most of the sentences and one separate color for the furigana. So the days that I have more time to spend on language learning, I would learn the language for 2 to 3 hours. I take a more extensive notes, but when I have like a couple of hours or just 30 minutes that I do daily for language learning, I would take like very quick notes in one with one pen, so with in one color. So this is like more extensive notes. So this notebook is far from full, so I'm still using it. Another notebook that I use very much is this one, and it has some different, like, it's a subject notebook, and that's this notebook I like the most because you can just open it easily and just, yeah, use it like this. And it has all this different subjects space. So this is my vocabulary notebook. I started out learning vocabulary in here, and I wanted to have all the vocabulary that I learned in one place, and I started just writing them out. And then I realized that this wasn't the way of to learn things, because when I would look back on my notes, I realized that most of the vocabulary I still didn't remember. And then I switched to a different system, which was again using sentences and coloring every sentence, every word in the sentence. Then this would take a lot of work, and again I wouldn't remember all of things. So I stopped doing that, and I just started using simple sentences and stopped using a lot of colors. And I have different Instagram challenges that I do to learn new vocabulary. And most of the time I'm not really good at finishing these challenges, so when I don't want to do it anymore, I just stop doing it. Another way how I use it is for grammar. So all of the grammar structures that I use through apps, textbooks or internet, I will write down in here. So right now this is not the only notebook that I use for my internet studies, because I realize most of the time that I study, I do study from internet and I do study from YouTube. So right now I use most of the time this notebook, and yeah, this one a little bit less. So the last thing that I write down in this notebook are my notes from my reading, Japanese readings. And one of the things that I read right now in Japanese is this book. So what I will do is write down every word that I don't know, and those are a lot of words. And yeah, I still need to go through to continue doing this. I just started out. And then all of the words that I learned from textbooks or from my reading, I will put down in the Anki app. So that's how I review my notes. So most of the time I won't like really look back at all the notes that I have taken, because I don't know, I just, it's not the way how I learn. And what I will do is the words that I want to remember or the sentences that I really want to remember, I just put down in the Anki app and review that every day. So my daily study for Japanese is half an hour doing Anki flashcards. So in the long studies that I do, like writing everything out, using these notebooks, it's something that I do 2 to 3 times per week, so not every day. Then my last notebook for Japanese, which is this one, I use this one the least, because this is only for textbooks. So all the notes that I have from textbooks I do in here. This one is from Japanese for Busy People. This textbooks, none of my textbooks I really finished, but this one I just stopped at first chapter. Then I started taking my notes for Nihongo Somotome in here. And now I'm realizing that I also have another book. Which one? It's this one. So this is the book that I'm learning from, and this is the notebook. So it's, yeah, it's very small. But here are all my notes from Nihongo Somotome. So I started out in here, but then I use this notebook only for all the textbooks and for Nihongo Somotome, because I really started learning for the JLPT. I used a separate notebook, which is this one. But right now I do a lot of learning online. So a lot of YouTube learnings and a lot of things from apps that I use. So not so much from textbooks. But yeah, back to this notebook. This is only for textbook, and one of the things that I use it the most for is Genki. I will write down all the vocabulary that I learned in the chapters from Genki, all the grammar and things like that. And on the back side, I use it for the textbook Tai Kim, which is a grammar textbook. So this is everything for Japanese notebooks. Then I have a separate notebook for Korean, which is only one notebook because I just started out and I don't want to use all kinds of different notebooks. And in here, I just learn the writing system. I write my goals down and every lesson that I follow online on YouTube. And in the separate subject space, I use it for Korean from zero. And what I find important, again, I'm not going back to review all of these notes. What I do is every word that I learn in Korean from zero or in a YouTube lesson, I will put in my Anki flashcards. So I make my own flashcards and use them every day. Then I have like this small notebook, which I take with me every day to like taking small notes on Japanese and also on Korean. What I do is most of it's vocabulary, and I will just write things out, which I see on Instagram or on Twitter, words that I don't know in a Twitter message or things that I don't know in Instagram post. I will just look it up in Jisho, which is an online dictionary for Japanese, and then write it in this notebook. So it's what I did for a couple of months now. It's not very full, but it has some information in it. And sometimes I have this post-it notes that I make at work about some words, and then I put it in here as well. But overall, I do have a lot of notebooks in my house, and I still buy new notebooks when I go to the store. I will always buy a new notebook, and most of the time I won't fill all of them and I won't finish all of those notebooks. So yeah, I try to limitate the amount of notebooks that I use for language learning, because then I will have this too much and I will forget where I put all of the information. So most of the time I try to use one notebook for Korean, and I try to use one notebook for Japanese, where I put most of my information, which is this one for now. So I hope you found this video interesting. Please leave a comment behind on how you take your notes. Do you use a notebook, or do you use your computer or iPad? I'm very interested in how you guys take your notes. So thank you for watching. Subscribe to this channel for more language learning videos. I upload videos every Sunday, once a week. Yeah, and I will see you next time. Bye.